regreso aquí en Auto 060 y ahora vamos a hablar con una invitada muy especial, Patricia Salas Pineda, que es la vicepresidenta del grupo del Hispanic Business Strategy de Toyota. ¿Cómo estás, Pat?
Muy bien. Thank you for having me.
No, thank you very much for your time. I know it's been a very busy weeks and months for you because you're starting a new project and then like you're starting a new thing here for this event coming up, the Hispanic Size Conference here in Miami. So thank you for your time.
Pleasure.
Okay, so let's, you've been, first of all, let's talk a little bit about you and your role in Toyota. You've been in Toyota for a long time, like about 30 years, right?
That's right. That's right. I started out as a lawyer with the company and actually served as a lawyer for about 25 years and served in the capacity as general counsel of a joint venture between Toyota and General Motors. And then more recently, I was general counsel of Toyota's holding company in the United States, Toyota Motor North America. I also served and transitioned to overseeing the Toyota USA Foundation and National Philanthropy for Toyota. And recently, this last year, I transitioned into a new role, and that is a role to develop the Hispanic business strategy.
Well, so like, I mean, almost like it doesn't sound like there's anybody else more adequate for that kind of job, because you've seen the company grow in the U.S., right? I mean, the Toyota has been for a long time, in probably longer in the U.S., but you've seen a lot of how they have developed their business here in the States and the importance of the Hispanic community.
Yes.
So tell me about it. You were talking about like you were in charge of the partnership with GM. That's when you guys had a factory in California, right?
Yes. Yes, we did, in Fremont, California. And I left after being there for 20 years, and I came to New York to join the holding company in 2004.
Yeah.
And I served as general counsel of the holding company and then started to lead the Toyota USA Foundation and the National Philanthropy.
So, Pat, like, you've seen all the aspects probably from the company since you were going and working for, like, the manufacturing aspect of it in the factory in California and then, like, with the foundation. So how have you seen the growth of the Hispanic both into the company, inside the company, and, like, that relationship of Toyota with the community outside the company here in throughout the United States?
Well, I've actually seen it evolve in a very positive way. You know, I feel so proud to work for a company that, you know, I joined the company through the venture in 1984. And from day one, the company always demonstrated a very strong commitment to diversity, which I have actually seen grow and grow over my 30-year career. And, you know, I'm very proud to say that we have a very strong relationship with the Hispanic community. You know, it's taken a lot of work. Toyota is the number one automotive choice for Hispanics, and that really has required us to offer great products that meet the needs and lifestyle of Hispanic consumers. And I'm proud to say that, you know, it's been over 20 years that we actually started marketing to Latinos with a dedicated Hispanic agency. And in my role overseeing the Toyota USA Foundation and National Philanthropy, building upon work in the past, we were able to develop very strong partnerships over the last decade with key U.S. Hispanic national organizations, and we continue to build a strong, visible presence at their annual conferences and events.
Yeah. So what kind?
So I see our relationship with the Hispanic community strong and growing.
Yeah. And so what kind of work, philanthropy work, does Toyota do in the Hispanic community here in the States currently?
So we actually have a focus on the environment, on education and vehicle safety, and we also support efforts around disaster-related events. And we, I'll give you some examples in the vehicle safety arena. Toyota has a program called Buckle Up for Life, or Abróchate a la Vida. And working with Cincinnati Children's Hospital Medical Center, Toyota has worked with the hospital to develop a program that targets Hispanic families as well as African American families through a program that addresses prevention and preparedness around family safety in vehicles. And I don't know if you are aware, but unfortunately, and this transcends Latinos, it's everyone in this country, two-thirds of car seats are improperly installed. So this program educates Hispanic and African American families on how to properly install a car seat. It also educates them on the importance of buckling up while in a vehicle. And so as children grow, going from a car seat to a booster seat, and the entire family participates, and we've seen great success. And it's a program that is continuing to grow. It's a national program, and we have added additional cities, and I think we are reaching close to, I think over the next few years, we will be near around 15 to 16 cities. And many of these cities that are part of the program have significant Latino populations.
Yeah, very important. And also, I mean, you do other programs like 100 Cars for Good, which is like a way of Toyota like actually giving out a car to different, not only Hispanic, but anybody who is doing like charity work around the country, right?
Yes, we do. And so that's been a great program, and it has touched a lot of organizations that serve the Hispanic population. We have also, you know, we have a focus on math and science K through 12, and the programs we support typically are programs that support diverse communities, and so Latinos have benefited from those programs. We also have a very important partnership with the National Center for Family Literacy that has targeted recent immigrants, including Latino immigrants, in teaching. Parent and child come to the program and both learn to read and write together. And through this program, parents also have the opportunity to develop computer skills. And I've been very, very fortunate in being able to attend a lot of the or observe a lot of the programs in various cities, and it's been incredible to see the great success. You know, when Latino parents feel invited into their children's schools, they engage heavily and become very involved in their children's education. And so it was really wonderful to see both parent, family, and the child, everyone flourishing.
Yeah. And Pat, also, I mean, Toyota does a great job about recruiting talent, right? Like, because one of your colleagues here there at Toyota, Javier Moreno, who is in charge in PR for the Hispanic market, he was recruited. I love his story because he was recruited out of a school of agriculture, nothing to do with cars, but obviously Toyota saw talent in him. So that's something else that that our audience and people who are looking for an opportunity to work in a company like Toyota should be aware of, right? So how can they approach Toyota to get into involved with that?
Well, you know, and before I transition to that, I also just want to tell you that Toyota to date has contributed over $700 million in the United States, and a significant portion of that has gone to organizations that serve the Hispanic community.
Yeah.
So in terms of commitment to diversity, you know, we are very much committed to diversity in the workplace, and we do post positions when they come open, and we go to the outside and always make it a point to consider a diverse panel of employees. Obviously, you know, we're always looking for talented Javier Moreno, so.
And Patricia Salas too, right?
Thank you.
Pat, I'm sorry, we're running. I mean, this is very interesting, but we're running out of time. We have like 30 seconds.
Okay.
But is there a website or something where our audience can go there and look for more information about Toyota and all the programs that you do?
Yes, so they can go to toyota.com.
Okay.
And they will see our website.
Excellent.
And there will be a listing when they go into the philanthropy section. They can find out about the different programs.
Excellent.
That we're currently supporting and have supported in the past.
Thank you. Patricia Salas Pineda, Group Vice President of Hispanic Business Strategy for Toyota. Thank you very much for your time, and I'll hope to see you soon here in Miami during Hispanic Size 2014, Pat.
Muchas gracias, Javier, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.